the unique cattle muster where man and beast go island hopping in picturesque Tasmania, and that's where Ray Martin travelled to witness a roundup he will never forget.
When Tasmania was still called Van Diemen's Land, Stanley was the first seaport. These days, it's best known for the Nut, the giant rock that protects this eternally tidy town from the wild westerly winds.
From up here on top of the Nut, you can see out there in the sea mist what the locals refer to as the edge of the earth. And that's where the great cattle drive is going to happen. Over $200,000 worth of prize beef moved in Bass Strait from one island to another.
We are doing something unique here, there's no doubt about that. Very few people in the world are grass-fattening Wagyu.
At $100 a Wagyu steak, the Hammond boys are understandably smiling.
It's a grass-fed product, and the salt air and the environment here makes the stuff a really nice product.
Do you smile when you look at that?
Yes, I usually smile more after I've eaten it.
It takes a couple of boats and a four-wheel drive just to get there. And then a big low tide, over 3 metres, to shift the cattle from Robbins Island to Walker Island, a turquoise beach stroll of about 8 kilometres.
Well, we try to be cow psychologists in our job, but we don't really know what they're thinking. We do our best.
But is the exercise and varieties the same for animals as people?
Oh, look, I think the change of diet, this roughage, they do like roughage.
But the fact that the air is the freshest in the world, the water's obviously the cleanest, does that contribute to a better piece of steak?
No doubt it does. Yeah, any time you can take stress out of an animal system, it's going to produce better and be more relaxed as it goes through life.
Come on, come on.
Keith Hammond and his older brother John were Tassie-born, but Oklahoma-bred.
Great-grandfather bought the islands in 1916, so it's come right through the generations. They had 3 dairies here and a cheese factory.
30 years ago, they came home to have a go at breeding the high-class Japanese Wagyu beef to become part farmers, part genetic scientists. New Age Keith prefers the quad bike and jokingly calls his brother the Marlboro Man without the cigarettes. Last week the word was passed around, as Banjo Patterson wrote, from the Midlands to the Tasmanian High Country, that there was a movement at the station out on Robbins Island, and so they all mustered overnight.
These are the days you live for, right?
It's becoming a dying art.
Beautiful day. Do something with the horses. Can't get any better than this.
The Hammond wives, Lisa and Rochelle, are hands-on farmers too. They call these bleak, isolated islands the coastal outback, but they love the place.
Well, it's just every day is different.
What do you love most about this living here?
The air and the environment. It's just so clean and
so pretty.
Why did you choose Wagyu beef? Why the hell?
We decided our market in the future would be Asia. That's the breed of cattle the Asians like. The Japanese weren't happy with the breed going out of Japan either. So it's a very sensitive issue for them because they're considered a national treasure. We've had to work on genetics and adapt somewhat to what will suit our environment the best through the different bloodlines.
And it's that clean green air that could decide the Hammond family's future and their fortune, way beyond the Wagyu beef.
This is the Cape Grim Air Monitoring Station. It's one of only a handful in the world and the only one in Australia. And the CSIRO is so precise about its monitoring that you can't even have a cigarette here. Yet every day they prove that the air here in Tasmania is the cleanest in the world, like the water and the winds that blow uninterrupted all the way from South America.
There's 60 of these giant wind turbines costing $500 million perched on the cliffs of a neighbouring property. The Hammond's dream of 260 windmills costing $3 billion, with who knows, enough wind power to light up Geelong.
One of the natural strengths this far northwest corner has is we have a lot of wind.
And Keith, every day you go out there and feel the wind, you think, damn it, where's that wind farm?
Well, we think it will happen and it's just a matter of when.
But for the moment, they're keeping their hoofs on the ground, all four.
There'll still be some things we do the old way. And I think we'll always be walking cattle between the islands and off Robbins Island back to the Tasmanian mainland, no matter what.
Beautiful story. Ray's in his element there.